He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, so for this practice problem, we have benzene. We're starting with benzene, and we are going to subject this to a series of four sets of reaction conditions. So take a look at these and think about what reactions we might need to be using, and see if you can come up with the correct product. So let's take a look at this. We've got benzene. We're starting with benzene. And what is the first thing we're going to do? So reaction one, we've got Br2 and FeBr3. So we've got benzene, we've got something aromatic, and FeBr3, this iron tribromide catalyst, that should be a tip-off. We know that we're doing electrophilic aromatic substitution. We know that we are going to brominate this benzene ring. So if we recall that reaction, this is electrophilic aromatic substitution with that iron tribromide catalyst. We know that we're going to get a bromine on there. Anywhere on the ring, we just throw a bromine on there. So that's reaction one. Then we've got reaction two. So what are we going to be using magnesium for? Probably at this stage of organic chemistry, there's really only one application. And when we see magnesium, we're thinking Grignard. We know that we're going to be generating a Grignard reagent. And so let's go ahead and make that Grignard reagent. We know that magnesium is going to insert itself into that carbon-bromine bond. So we know that we're going to get from Br, we're going to get MgBr. So magnesium, remember, in diethyl ether, that's going to give us our Grignard reagent, so that's where we are. Now, how about this third reaction? Let's talk about number three. We know that Grignard reagents will usually attack carbonyl-containing compounds. And so usually that's an aldehyde or a ketone. Sometimes we see this happening with an ester as well. But there is one special case. Here we see in two steps we've got CO2 followed by your typical aqueous acidic workup for a Grignard. CO2, how is that going to work? Well, it really behaves just like any other carbonyl-containing compound. We know that this carbon is going to attack here. And we're going to pop open, have that pi bond go up there into the oxygen. The only difference is there is another carbonyl there. And so when you do a Grignard with CO2, you actually are able to get a carboxylic acid. Right, so this followed by the aqueous acidic workup is going to protonate that oxyanion, and we do get benzoic acid here. So that's a little bit different than your typical Grignard, but that is what we're going to get here. That is the case with CO2. So we do want to remember that that is a special case. And then lastly, we know that lithium aluminum hydride is a very strong reducing agent. It is capable of reducing not just aldehydes and ketones, but also carboxylic acids and esters. So lithium aluminum hydride is able to take this all the way down to the primary alcohol. And so we do get this as our answer. So once again, we did electrophilic aromatic substitution. We did a bromination here, popped the bromine on there. The magnesium allowed us to make the Grignard reagent. Then we did a Grignard reaction with our Grignard reagent and CO2. To get benzoic acid, and then from there we reduced with lithium aluminum hydride to get this alcohol. And that is the product of this sequence of reactions. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.